John, I called to tell you that to wish you Merry Christmas and to tell you that I thought you did a fine job on your test thing. And
we'd ever thought of having 2 tenths months, 3 months in succession, we didn't.
said, "Doug, you're out of your mind." And I said, "Would it be fantastic?" Well, if we can keep it at about, not 2 tenths, but around 3 tenths next year, that's great. And I think we will. 3 tenths to 4 tenths. Boy, oh boy. What about rents?
Well, the Tom Curtis is coming with an explanation that goes pretty far. We've got the plans in February,
That's right, like Los Angeles, it's silly to have rent. Oh my God, they got too many rates in Florida.
That's the way I see it, in hell with it.
That's right. Excellent idea. And I would do it with the decontrol with as little fanfare as possible to get it done.
Yes.
Because if you decontrol, and it's a big story, then people think, they're getting up. Like just sort of slip it in on a weekend or sometime. There's another big story. Let it be a secondary story. The more you can handle those stories, the stories in this place, you can't win. So the thing to do is to service. The best way is to make very little publicity, except about the overall group figures of the Denver Victory. Would you agree?
That's a good idea.
Thank you.
Okay. Have a good Christmas. Don't worry about it for the weekend. Just watch football.
Sure.
Oh, incidentally, did you see, let me ask you, did you see Brian Fox? You know what I'm talking about? The Piccolo story? The Chicago Bulls, 1965-66, Piccolo got cancer and died. He and so his close friend. ABC had made a movie out of now and again. I saw it. It was a beautiful movie with very emotional. And I was having it put on at the White House Monday night. Anybody in the White House family would like to see it in the theater. And I would urge you to bring your children. It is a beautiful story. It is the best story on race relations. It'll do more good in race relations than anything I have seen in years. It's that good. It shows how Sayers and Piccolo wound together. Be sure to come soon. Okay. I'm back.
I know that somebody might have a factory, very instructive, going to Now, we and I mentioned earlier, we go up. If that's so, then our line is a common line.
Before that, I lost a small bar in my back. I like the pain dance. And, you know, that Thanksgiving went to my house and say that Bill had lost our relations up and maybe even him.
Thank you. Thank you.
even eliminated the association with you.
That's into your terms.
Okay. Second, not the presence of any Soviet unions, but Soviet personal unions made the mission.
That's right.
Some limited, I said it's for the limited number of advisors for duly advisory. In Turkey, you can
get into the second organization.
Yeah. I guess they're looking for a good kind of lawyer who would, at least it had a story. The only one I know who's as good as I am.
Of course, you're without good. I'm squealing from the
There's an annual
seminar. Well, the fun of the Columbia is the one that you might have a good time.
What is your,
I'm not so sure that it's, I think we can just talk for a little bit. It is a good thing.
I would tell me about the way it is, and I got to fix it.
They all mean so much.
Not because Kuchi died, but because Beijing's leadership is so bad. I mean, frankly, in California, it's Reagan, and you can't do it around him. He's going to do it in Reagan as a try.
There's no reason for him to be in Michigan.
That's what I told all of them yesterday. I said, Colson must hire him.
Right.
And then that
you've got to stay in just long enough to launch him, and that's all you need to do, and then and that'll be done.
That's all I wanted.
Now, could Clausen be the man?
I think so. I've been thinking about that. The only people that need to be retained, Mr. President, Belzano, because it's a big signal to a lot of people. Rogers, because you've got to have a
labor. Right.
And Clausen. And you need, beyond that, you don't need anything except just a couple of, well, damn good.
Would you put Clausen in, basically make him the information man, or make, or really keep, give him another task? That damn information thing, you know, we've got to keep the office just for purposes of appearance, but if somebody suggests maybe just give Warren that and let him fart around with that sort of stuff, but because he's not a bad fellow.
No, he's a good fellow.
But what would you think?
Clausen understands it. He also understands it.
No, but I mean, what I want Clausen for is not for information. I want him for nut cutting.
That's right.
See?
That's right. Well, you could leave him. You could. It wouldn't make any difference, Mr. President, whether you just had him.
Yeah, to, but can Clausen manage? Have you ever seen whether he could manage a staff? Can he hire a staff? Is he good at that sort of thing?
Yeah, I think he's damn good at that. He's.
How's his judgment? Is he?
His judgment is good.
Yeah.
Now, the place where he's weak is he hasn't. Well, no, like, he's gotten more, but I was going to say he hasn't had the exposure to the to the people outside that you have to know. The thing that you have to give to.
But you see, the point is, there is a place where you can give the stroke. You see, what we need is the only way your thing will work is to have the man in and the man out.
That's
so
correct.
You see my point?
That was the point I did.
Yeah. Now, if you have that, and then it's all known, like the way I would do this, I would call in, then I would call in Fitz, and we could do all about 10-minute appointments. Paul Hall, others, and I say, we're going to set this up, and this is the fellow that's going to see. Chuck's going to have this law firm, and so forth. Incidentally, did Bob pass on to you my thought that I thought you should set up basically a polling organization?
No, that's a very interesting idea.
What I thought was not your own polling organization.
Right.
I mean it so much as that you'd sort of be in charge of polls, and then we go all through the government and be sure that no polls are taken except by people that we want, and then you feed them out.
Oh, that's a hell of a
you, in other words, feed them to that.
That's
so forth and so on.
Oh, exactly.
You feed them to Sidlinger, feed them to Harris, and even to Gallup. I mean, the point is, let's just get the polling done our own way. I'll bet you we're having many of our enemies poll
the
present time.
No. Well, the reason, of course, we brought Harris around, Mr. President,
yeah,
we got to the point where we were writing his stuff.
That's right.
But we were important to him business-wise.
That's right.
We should be the same way.
But I thought that if you could set up what I was thinking of, the way you could do it would be under the cover of maybe, you remember Spencer Roberts in Los Angeles?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you set up outside your law office, and I wouldn't put it in names. I wouldn't call it Colson.
Oh, no, no.
Something like that. I would just say Washington Associates or something like that. See my point?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And get a good, high-sounding name. And then you go out, and then we'd know where to go. You do the polling, so forth. Now, the foundation is the other thing that is terribly important. And what you do, I don't know.
Well, I think what we ought to do, Mr. President, is, frankly, is to get one big contributor, the DeWitt Wallace-type fella, to put enough money into AEI, which is presently going at $2 million a year.
AEI would be still a pretty good vehicle, isn't it?
Well, change its name. In other words, if DeWitt Wallace would have put his money in, you'd call it the DeWitt Wallace Foundation. Get rid of the American Enterprise Institute, which is a lousy name.
Yeah.
But they've got an ongoing operation with $2 million a year. They've got a hell of a, now, computer bank of academics.
Mm-hmm.
They're right at the verge of being what we want.
Our Brookings.
Our Brookings.
And then, of course, Brookings is cut off right at the hip pocket.
Totally. I told Weinberger.
Yeah.
I was told Ash.
Check them all out.
Just get all their contracts.
And that's right.
There'll be no more from the federal government, period.
That's right.
No speakers.
And no speakers. That's the main thing. Because they use the speakers as chum.
Oh, of course. They pull them out of that State Department. And I just
tried
looked at next week's list of speakers and discovered that we've got three going over. I just said, no, cancel them.
Did you get that? Did you get it canceled? Good.
Well,
well, you got to get Stein to quit going over there, too.
Well, he's been one of the biggest vendors because he came from there. But
I know.
But we can get that under control. That's the kind of thing. But you see, the point I made to Haldeman Friday, which I assume he raised with you from what you're saying, you've got to have somebody in the White House who does a few essential functions, one of which is to enforce this. In other words, I've been doing that to discipline that is necessary to accomplish what has to be accomplished, who's a kind of a counterpart with all the things that are going on the outside, and that can be the guy that does a little mobilizing and the public support when you need it, and that's when you need it.
All right.
Public support, I mean.
I understand. I understand totally. You've got to have the capability, and I talked to Connolly yesterday on the phone. He was in Texas, and he agreed we've got to have the capability. He thinks a capability with a lower profile.
That's right.
Having in mind that the election is over, and he's totally in on the thing of having the outside operation. He said you've been damn fools not to have a Clark Clifford and so forth. So he's delighted with that. So he sees the whole thing.
Well, I talked to Connolly, but on Friday, and he just said, "You get out, Chuck." He said, "I think you can do so much in the Clifford type of operation."
Incidentally, one last point we're going to talk about. What is your feeling, Chuck, about the Dent office? Would you retain that?
What I would do, Mr.
You see, we have nobody in the political field at the present time. Could you see Haldeman and Ehrlichman are not considered to be basically loyal Republicans, but what would you do there?
I would have...
Let me ask you one thing. Dent has a sick wife, but she's now got her in Washington. Suppose he'd be willing to stay. Would that be the best solution?
Who, Harry Dent?
Yeah.
I think I do. I think Harry would be the best.
Everybody knows him and so forth.
And he's symbolic. And if he would stay, yes. My thought was, and I told this to Bob, that you take the Colson operation, which was basically to reach out into the country and mobilize public support. You take one person like Colson who can deal with columnists and
right.
when you need to. Not that they,
sure.
well, we're doing anything for them, but when we want to use them. And the political operation. And you put it all together in one low-profile, small, tight unit. But at least you've got a place people can go to. You've got a place where the nut cuts.
And have the stuff prepared, like you would force then Ehrlichman to, which through his deals and through our strength, and see, we're going to name all the PIOs out through the government now anyway.
Right.
We would then force them to prepare the counterattack materials.
Yep.
We know how it's a weak read, but they're... But we'll see. We'll see what we get there.
That's an area that would depend, Mr. President.
Of course, Buchanan will still be here.
That's right. And if you make it, we could destroy the campaign. We made Buchanan the editor-in-chief, and he reviewed everything that was prepared. And then I funneled it out through
the other thing you would do would be what? Beyond that, you'd have Clausen in it, but what would you do with the political side, like the, how do you have the party represented? You'd have Dent or a person like that.
You have Balzano, Rogers.
Yeah.
And then, of course, Buchanan for writing and editing, and then probably just a couple of very low, Larry Higbee types who can just keep everything running. That's basically what you need.
No, but what do you do about basically what we call the Dent office?
I'd either have Harry or one man like him.
Mm-hmm.
And if I were you...
Where would you put him?
I'd put him under the same umbrella as the...
What will you call this office?
Well, what it really is the outside contact office. That's really what you're talking about.
We could just call it the...
Well, you call it the general...
We'll find a name, but the point is that's what it is. You'd have them all under that kind of an operation. They all ought to work together, be under the same roof.
Well, they really have to. And there are times when you're going to need to reach out.
Right.
And that's the group, frankly, Mr. President, that reaches out for you. It's kind of a switchboard, and it's there to...
Right.
I mean, even though you're going to move a lot of responsibilities out to departments, you kind of use this operation to funnel people. I mean, if Marzullo or Rizzo has a problem, they got a place they can call, and you refer them out to the department. The political people they want liaison, they know at least where they can come and talk. It gives me, on the outside, someone to work with every day rather than bothering John or Bob or who wouldn't have to just do that. They're busy. It's a sounding board. It's the place you purge the enemy. It's the nut cutting. It's where you do work on getting the attack line out when you need one. It can be very, very small, but you, depending on just having good people in it, if you had a combination of a Clausen and a Dent, or someone into the party as well as Dent, and Balzano and Rogers, that's what you're talking about.
Right.
Maybe this young fellow, Mickey Gardner, if we could get him.
Well, but Mickey Gardner's not a Republican.
No, but that's good.
I'd have, well, who who the hell's going to be the...
I mean...
You've still got to have somebody to be the contact with the National Committee types. That's what I mean.
That's right.
Don't you agree?
I do. I think
Gardner, I'd love to get him for anything.
Well, I'm trying to, because I'd like to get him to work in this general area or somewhere.
Yeah.
Who's going to have
an
office that does this.
Yeah.
He would be great, because he's a terribly shrewd young fellow. No, you need one man who, like Harry Dent, is recognized as the political guy. If Harry would stay, he'd be fine. If Harry wouldn't stay, I think I could... I'm sure they're for...
We could find somebody.
Oh, sure.
Well, some of the best people that developed out of the campaign, basically.